My college dad actually had this ring before, and I was asking him like how he found it and whether it was quiet and stuff like that.
It's some real memories, those stuff.
Also, the college dad was in the public and the only one, so that was my friend.
You're ruining your final year, so it's a different function in your life.
There's your corner where you work.
Next year, you'll be out of here. It's not a high school, call yourself out.
Equation,
call yourself in.
Bed as well, I remember I was right there, it's just a bed. There was one day, I sat there for 24 hours reading a whole book. We're going to take the lights on, so we just wanted to light on the bed. It's actually quite lovely, it's like having a little retreat in the corner of the room.
Back in 1998, there were no more bug phones, little contact by email.
It's really, they're just on the bed. Lovely, and go down there and just think on the internet, so it was very exciting.
We sent letters, you could lose yourself. This room was my haven, my nest.
It's social media now, we're never really that disconnected from anyone.
Absolutely, also spend time telling yourself how important this place has been in your life. What was this progressive, challenging, fun place?
You can't just have the same kind of individual identities like that. Yeah, Wollongong definitely still has that reputation.
And you also look back in more detail at how the beautiful relationship really began.
Yeah,
tell me about that.
Yeah, it was really sunny, bright autumn day, and like we're driving down Sandy Road, and then suddenly you get all these yellow brick colleges just kind of coming out of nowhere, and you get quite excited and pull up at one, and you're like, oh, so this is my home now. it's quite strange.
You also get territorial.
I'm definitely proud of Wollongong. Like, I really love Wollongong. I love her.
Makes me really happy.
And I really think about like all the other people who have been here as well.
I had a friend who said he lived in my room, the year after me, a kind of bra of mine in the cupboards. That was not.
She didn't say that.
I thought she just gave it. Well, Stephen Home never leaves you, really. You nurtured yourself in it. Ready for a week. Fluffed your wings here on your own. Wherever you go, however old you get, you take that place and I've felt in you.
It's really been the best of loving those times, really. But you know, just walking up both the staircases I've been in today, I have felt very emotional actually, because they're like, oh, because so many, it's going to make me sound about 300, but there's a lot of formative experiences in my life were in my home in staircase one, my home in staircase 10. All the friends I had, books that I read that I loved, you know, the first piece of journalism I did, and this really, really, really felt like home.
Well, tomorrow at this time, June Rogers heads to where the streets are paved with gold. Flat shares are still affordable. Doorstepping was produced by Sarah Jane Hall.
It is living up to any first performance of Rock, to say the least. So this series, I hope, will provide listeners with a kind of backstage pass to meet the actors, the writers and directors who are making some of the most compelling theatre that you'll see anywhere in the world.
BBC Radio 4's new monthly programme about theatre.
I'm Janice Forsyth, very much looking forward to presenting the first edition of Opening Night, particularly as we'll be meeting some of the country's most exciting theatre makers as they gear up for their opening nights at the Edinburgh Festival and Fringe in their 17th anniversary year.
On Saturday afternoon at 3:30, and then available on the Radio 4 website.
News at 2 o'clock. The government has warned energy companies that it hasn't ruled out a price cap after British Gas announced it was increasing its electricity prices by 12.5%. Labour has called the rise extortionate. Inpatients are to be moved from the trauma unit at the John Radcliffe Hospital in Oxford because of fears about fire safety. The building's cladding is to be replaced because of failings detected after the Grenfell Tower disaster. Medical Director for the Oxford University Hospitals Trust, Dr. Tony Barron, said some patients elsewhere in the hospital would be sent home to free up beds for those in the trauma unit.
We're working very closely with partners in social services, the county and city councils, our commissioning group, to identify packages of care and other locations for patients who can be safely located, indeed will probably benefit from being moved out of a hospital closer to home or towards their final destinations of care.
The European Commission has defended changes to security procedures which have been blamed for long waits at airports. In April, rules came into force requiring all EU citizens crossing the EU's external borders to be checked against European-wide databases. The lobby group Airlines for Europe, which represents EasyJet, Ryanair and British Airways, said passengers at airports in Spain, Portugal, France and Italy have been forced to stand in line for 4 hours. The spokesman commissioned by the price of security. The Labour MP Stephen McCabe has been hit on the head with a brick or a rock after demonstrating with 2 motorcyclists to degree lanes in the road in his Birmingham City constituency. He said motorists and motorbike riders have been intimidating whole neighbourhoods and that police were in danger of losing control of the streets. The RALI says a man who drifted a mile out to sea off the coast of Redham in North Yorkshire in a toy dinghy was lucky to be alive. So the man barely fit in and invisible. BBC News.
This is BBC Radio 4. Now, it's struggling in the office.